Good evening, and welcome back to Stardew Valley. I'm Odia Parandis. Let's see what's going on with the weather tomorrow. First of all here, ooh, Queen of Sauce also. Forecast is clear and sunny, okay. And the Queen of Sauce has for us the maple bars. Ever notice how the maple bars are always the first to disappear from the donut box? Perplexing, because your average maple bar tastes like a sweet hockey puck. Agree? Well, just wait until you try my recipe. You can really taste the forest in these bars. Okay, you're going to need real quality maple syrup. Something we can finally do with maple syrup. Okay, let's take a look at maple bars. Oh, morning. Need some coffee. Oh, thanks, honey. My morning just would be complete without a hot cup of coffee. I agree. I usually drink like 3 in the morning. Maple bar. This one. Sugar, wheat, flour, and maple syrup. 225. Oh, plus fishing, plus farming, plus mining. An all-around good thing. Wow. That's not bad. Wheat flour is pretty cheap, and so is sugar. And maple syrup we're getting all the time. That's a really cool thing. Bonuses to like every single chore you can imagine, which is nice. Good all-around meal then. Okay, so we got lots of junk we have to take care of in our inventory here. Our energy is low, so I'm gonna actually take this coffee right away here. Ooh, are these grown? Oh man, we're gonna have a lucrative day here. We got our melons grown, we have our blueberries grown, we have this to drop off here. A bunch of trash to get rid of. I don't know if I'm gonna even refine trash anymore. It doesn't seem worth it to me. Aside from the stuff that makes quartz, I don't think we're gonna do it anymore. Makes torches and paper and nothing we actually want. Oh, this seaweed we might hang on to actually though. Oh, gravel path, I guess we can toss. And the seaweed, I guess we'll throw into here for now. It's cooking recipes, right? We need it for that. I guess we'll save it for our other inventory then. Okay, and then, moment of truth. We need one gold star from here. Come on. Come on. Really? Not a single one? Man, okay. So it's the 14th. We need some quality fertilizer on here then. We have a couple more chances at this. It's Sunday. Okay, let's do this. Let's do that. Let's get these turned into seeds. Replanted quick. We can only do one more chance at this. And then we're stuck till next season. I can't have that. I think maybe we should double down and maybe do more even. This is the high quality fertilizer though. This should do the job, but I'm kind of tempted to just do one more just to be sure. Do we have any more quality fertilizer? I think I can make some. It just takes fish and sap. And we have 3 fish here and sap. It takes 1 fish per thing. Holy cow, that's expensive. And time consuming. Holy cow. All right. Yeah, let's get those rest of those seeds out of here. 3 more. Okay, cool. Yeah, so I think there's a pretty good chance. If we do high quality, we should upgrade our farming skills. That's what we'll do next time. Maybe we'll upgrade our farming before we do that. But look at this. All of this will become wine. If nothing else, we have this for wine. Blueberry wine or blueberry jam. We got 32 blueberries from that for our very first harvest. We'll get at least a couple more here. And that sells for usually, these sell for 80, which puts it on par with, and what are green beans? So the green beans, if we turn this into jam, the green beans sell for about, what, 200 roughly? Right? No, they sell for about 190, I want to say. So blueberries will be sold for more than that if we turn them into jam. So it's perfect. Okay, so let's put all of this into our bin over here, first of all. No, don't eat the blueberries. Hang on to that for now. So this will make a bunch of wine if we need it. If we run out of things to make wine with, this will save for wine too. Man, I can't believe we can get a single decent melon out of that. And really, we only have one more chance at it, man. We hopefully, this one will grow fast because it's on the quality or the speed grow. I'm nervous that we're not going to make it. I don't know what we're going to do then. Let's play for another year then. We got to make it. Just one has to be good. I think that's what we'll do though. We'll raise our farming skill up before we harvest it next time. Maybe that'll help. I don't know if that increases the chance of quality crops. You'd think that you'd have to have it like going the entire time. for your farming skill to be, you know, reflective of your farming, like, you know, choices and actions and stuff like that. Like, you can't just, like, be a good farmer when you pick stuff. You have to be a good farmer the entire time. Could be wrong, though. So we're going to have no shortage of things to make in our brewery. That said, our brewery is massive once we get it done. So, yeah, we're gonna fill it up. We're going to fill it up multiple times. And it's going to last us a long time. Every other day, pretty much, we're going to have something else going here. It's going to be so lucrative when this happens, though. Oh, my God, I can't wait for all that cash to start rolling in. We just need... How many more kegs do we actually need? Holy cow. Let's see. 1, 2, 3... Was this 4? 4 times 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. It's 28 more kegs. Plus another handful here. This is another 4, so it's 32. Another 5 here, so that's 37 more kegs. Holy cow. We are going to need a lot more oak resin. If I ever see it for sale anywhere, I'm going to buy it. I don't think we will see it for sale anywhere, but maybe from the traveling merchant occasionally. Speaking of, it's Sunday. We should go talk to him. There's a couple more spots over there. I kind of want to put the other melons in there just in case. We got to pull out all the stops here because this is the one thing holding us back. If we don't get this, we do have one more chance, actually. If we don't manage to get the melons, we can do the pumpkins instead. And you can guarantee if we have to wait for the pumpkins, I am going to be doing the entire field as pumpkins, pretty much, just so we make sure we get 5 good ones. I'm going to take out some of these bad ones here and replant those seeds here one more time. And actually, we should probably save some melon seeds for the greenhouse in case we want melons instead of... I mean, starfruit's going to be the major crop for us, I think, in the greenhouse. It takes a long time to grow is the issue with that. Cranberries grow a little faster, so that probably would be more lucrative over time. But just the idea of selling, like, you know, $1,000 bottle of wine kind of thing would be... That's appealing to me. So we want to do the high-quality wines, I think. And we can do cranberry wine, I'm sure, but... I really want to get like the most expensive wine we can possibly brew and see how that sells. Okay, we got one more chance right here. Put this quality on it and then drop this. Now, why was that? I mean, it's next to the scarecrow, right? So it should have been fine. I haven't encountered any crows yet. Okay, I don't know. It should be covered. All right, so hopefully this stuff grows. Hopefully it grows quickly. Hopefully everything goes well with that. It's already 11 o'clock. We still got to take care of our animals. So we're not going to get much done today. A lot of running around. Oh, are you a happy cow yet? Come on, large milk. Low milk. I think when we get to 3, we'll be good. Oh, that's close. We got it. Yes, we're one step closer to our goal. We got large milk. We need a goat milk. Okay, buying a goat today. That's what we're doing today. We're going to buy a couple goats and start leveling them up. Show the goats all the love we can. Make sure all the chickens are talked to. Even the babies. And the ducklings over here. There's somebody over here. There he is. I've been looking up female city names. So I got a list of baby names for City girl baby names, basically. Girl city. I don't know what the order of that should be. So baby names of cities. That still doesn't sound right. But you know what I mean. And I looked up a bunch of some baby website for baby names. And yeah, so we had a lot. I got a list to go off of now. So I don't have to think about it so hard. I don't know. I cut out all the time I spend thinking on this, actually. The magic of editing here. If you guys were early watchers to one of these episodes here, you might have caught me. I put up a version that had all of my thinking in there of how long it takes me to come up with one of the names for one of the chickens. It was a little embarrassing, so I re-uploaded that. But yeah, it takes a good long while for me to come up with a good name for these guys. I just cut all that for the sake of ease of recording here and ease of the viewers. You guys don't need to hear me thinking for 10 minutes of what should I name this thing? I think the names have been pretty good so far, though, if I don't say so myself. Fitting, good names, fits what I was going for, so that's kind of nice. All right, looks like we have... I don't think we need the duck egg. We did everything we need to do with the duck eggs, so we can just put these all in the makers here, of course. And we got 2 extras, or 1 extra. All right, so we got to get down to Marnie, talk about some goats. So let's go get some goats, and we got our names picked out already. I don't have my names picked out exactly, and actually I can't see my list at the moment here, and so I don't know what to do with it. So maybe I might have to wing it here in a second. My biggest problem is we got a lot of the good ones already. Oh, here we go. Hi, Marnie. A lot of the good names I've already thought up here, just on my own. All right, pick a barn for the goats. Bumbo is not a good name. Let's see, where's my list? Okay, I got a list here, and the next one will be, let's see. Savannah. All right, yes. Savannah the goat, and we'll do one more for good measure. One more goat. And this one will be the city of, or the city of, or the country of Jordan. How about that? We didn't do any countries yet. So, Jordan. Also some cities named Jordan, I'm sure. But little Jordan on the way. Cool. So, we got Jordan and... what did I name the one? Savannah. Yes, that's right. So that takes care of my names. I have three more listed here. You can guess in the comments what they are. I mean, you could probably look up the most common girl baby names of cities and come up with the answer too. Savannah seems a little curious, but cautious. Jordan, these guys are awesome. Welcome. Welcome, ladies. Welcome to the farm. We're getting a menagerie going here. So next, we need to get the upgrades for the chicken coop so we can get rabbits is the next upgrade. And that's going to be quite expensive. We have a little bit of cash left over here still. So we can do that. Let's turn this milk into cheese here quick. And then we got to save this other milk for the community center. And then I think we got to run over to the traveling merchant quick here. So all that off. And there's a battery that has popped up, I think. Nope. Oh, that is one here. Yeah. I guess we just leave them in there until it storms next. Then we gotta take them out. So maybe I'll stop grabbing them. Man, we got 14 batteries. We can sell these off too if we need some extra cash, because we probably won't need that many batteries, to be honest. We will need more sprinklers at some point, but 14 sprinklers? I don't know if we'll ever have that so much iridium unless we find a better way of getting it. There's just not that many hours in the day, I feel like. So we have one seed of the melons. That's all we need to get more. I mean, we can always turn those ones we grow back into seeds using the seed things here. And we always get at least two back. So when you put a melon in, you always get at least two seeds back every single time. So that's good. Oh, we got something grown over here. What is it going to be? Please tell me it's oak resin. Oh, my gosh. Yes. So my whole idea of pathing these things so that they don't have, garbage accumulating on them is completely inaccurate. They still have garbage all over them all the time. So the fact of having the paths all laid out here with coverings on it, it's not good enough. I wonder if I did floor, if it wouldn't have... Oh, I think that's the key, is I need to put floor down instead of path. This gravel path gets grown over very, very easily. It's a cheap thing. So yeah, I do need to improve that, I think. Did we get all of them now? All right, so that's our oak resin. What do we need for the kegs again? I think I ask this every single time. Clay, wood, copper, iron, oak resin. Okay. So we'll think on that. We got seven more. At this rate, it's gonna take us, what is it, like 11 days between things here? Okay, eight in there. Okay, we have seven. We need more copper. Anymore. We have enough wood, probably. We have enough clay for sure. So there's more copper. That's all we got room for in there. That should help. Okay. Gets us back up to speed there. Okay. One more here. Anything in here? Oh, look at all the wine that grew. Oh my gosh, all the wine is ready. Oh, beautiful harvest. Our very first harvest for the vineyard. I mean, this is not the very first, but it's getting better and better every single time. I can't wait to see how much cash this gets us. And it'll be just the beginning. It'll be just the beginning. It's a fraction of what's going to happen later. This is all grape wine, too, so it's the cheap stuff. And actually, we'll give some of this coconut wine, spice berry wine, we have cactus fruit wine, and we have grape wine. What should we use up? Let's just use up the blackberries here because we have so many of those sitting here. Let's use up the spice berries. Let's try some of the melons in there. So that should do it. A variety of things to make this with. And that might not be enough. What else can we put in there? Let's use grapes for the remainder, maybe. This is going fast here. Okay, so spice berries, melons. Blackberries. Wow. And then just grapes and the rest. So we'll save the cheap stuff for Leah, the grape stuff, because that doesn't sell for as much as the other things will, just by default, because the grapes are not as valuable. But she will appreciate it nonetheless. So let's give that. Let's save some of those for her, and make sure she gets a bottle today. From our first harvest, our first big harvest, I would say. Pretty beautiful. We might remember to water our hay here in a second. So let's save, not in there. Let's save it in here. Let's save like six of these. What's this one? Rhubarb wine. We want to sell that off. Let's save six. We'll actually drop one off for her right now. And then we'll sell off the good stuff here. So we'll sell off the rhubarb wine. We got a rhubarb vintage. We got cactus fruit wine, spice berry coconut wine, and the grape we'll sell off as well. And then the... Oh, we need more grape back. Okay, I sold off one too many grapes. Oh, we'll just grab one back. All right, honey, I'm bringing you some wine. Oh, you know what? I just saw something. It's so quiet and peaceful in the evening. Nothing to distract you from the experience of living. Except this. Oh, this is exactly what I wanted. Thank you. We missed the traveling merchant for the day, unfortunately, but we got distracted by all of our money. We counted our pennies, and look at all this. Oh my gosh, this is going to be a really good day for money. This might be the best day we've ever had for money. With the combination of the wines and the green beans going at the same time here. And, oh, we got the oak resin too. Okay, so let's do this. We need to make more iron too for this. We need the clay, we need the wood. Okay, so let's get some more barrels made here quick. Make sure we get enough iron in here too. I was thinking we need to come up with a name for our brewery though. I don't know what we want to call it exactly. Something fancy? Something fancy sounding. Like, what are some famous... I can't even think of any famous wine companies, though. Besides, like, the obvious, like, Cristal. Something like that, you know? Dom Perignon, Champagne. But, that's about it. Alright, so let's make the kegs up quick here. That should be 7. Cool. And we'll get those put in. And then that'll pretty much take us to the end of the day here. Oh my gosh, this is gonna be amazing. Make sure these get something in them right away. This is gonna be so good. Maybe I want to leave the last one blank here so I can run up and down. So I can go up and then down and then up and then down. Might not be a bad idea to do that. Then we'll have one less to worry about making. We'll have one less for our purposes here, but I think it'll be for the ease of you know. Well, then again, we go up one side, down one side, up one side, down one side. I guess it makes sense to do it all the way back then. So we'll do it all the way back. We'll maximize the space. Because, yeah, we'll go up here, and then down here, and then up here, and then down. No, no, we'll skip one, skip this row, and then go up here and down here. Yeah, that's what we'll do. I'm trying to think of, like, the most efficient way of doing this. It's going to happen, like, once every, you know, just once in a while here. You know, what is it, like, 4 or 5 days? To get that stuff to brew. Make sure we turn stuff into there. We're almost out of grapes already. Holy cow. Do we have anything else? Let's not use the grapes right away. Oh, we'll make pale ale with the rest of it. So the pale ale probably doesn't take as long. as the wine does. So that makes it a little bit quicker, but I don't think it's as lucrative. I think it still pays off to do the longer term thing. I guess we'll take that out of there. We don't need to save it. I was going to say we could keep the materials in there, but I'm going to forget about it, and then we're going to come back for it anyways. Oh, there's our one more barrel, though. One more barrel? Maximize it. Get it done today. Why wait, right? And then we'll get these green beans, pickled green beans, into the hopper. And then, we need one more thing to pickle here. One more thing to brew. One more pale ale. Okay. Sweet. All right, let's go sell off these green beans, drop off all of our crafting materials, and then we'll take on the next day here. Full of adventure. Okay, that's good. And then this will go in here. All right, so I can't wait to see the totals at the end of the day here. Gonna be pretty good. All right, let's get to sleep and we'll see what the damage was. Okay, I was anticipating at least 10 grand, but let's see. The rhubarb wine sells for 990. Wow. Coconut wine, it sold for... Let's see, I can't do the math on that in my head, but five of those, 10 of those would be 225 each, so it would be 550 each that I came up with there. This sold for 360 each. So rhubarb wine rhubarb is the way to go. Maybe we need to buy some rhubarb seeds and see... Yeah, because I think she sells the rhubarb year-round, I want to say. Sandy at the desert here. Pickles always did well, and the grape wine sold pretty well. Coconut wine's a little better, obviously. And spice berry's a little bit better than that, even, I think. No, coconut wine's better for than everything here, except for the rhubarb. Cool. That's good to know. Coconuts are pretty useful. I don't think we can make coconut trees over here, though. But we can always get those, at least. So if we ever need to restock our wine supplies, just head to the desert and do it. All right. Tackling another day halfway through the month. A little more than halfway through the month now. It's summer. That means the house is full of flies. Oh, let's see what the... Oh, living off land and the weather report for tomorrow says... Storm approaching. Okay, now we gotta make sure we have all of our things cleared out today. Welcome to living off the land. I know it's hard, but stop worrying so much about your horse. You can leave him anywhere, and they'll make their way back home. They're very smart, independent animals. Yeah, I thought we already figured that out, actually. Oh, we got a letter. Dear Farmer Modi, I'd like to give my wife a star fruit for our anniversary. Are you growing any on your farm? If you brought me one, I'd be grateful. Kent. Yeah, of course, Kent. We got you covered, man. Got you on lockdown. Soldier star. Nice. Yeah, dude. Well, we'll get you some brownie points for your lady, of course. Happy to help. Nope, don't eat the blueberries. Man, got stuff to pick every single day now, too. It's probably not the best layout for the crops here that we could come up with, because it does take a lot to walk around these sprinklers. Once we get the iridium sprinklers in, we probably could figure out a better system for this. We just don't have the iridium yet, though. And we're not going to for the foreseeable future. It's so hard to come by. But yeah, this blueberries are... I mean, we're getting a ton of blueberries every single day so far. I mean, probably every other day maybe for those. But hops we're going to be stocked up on. So, I mean, worst case scenario, we start making beer instead of wine. It's still a lot of cash every single day. And I think hops are every other day. Here they're growing every single day. You can make pale ale every other day. So it probably would even out that we're making a ton of money still. All right, let's make sure all the animals are cared for. Nope, wrong way. Nope, regular milks today, that's okay. Make sure these guys are happy. These guys are happy. How are you doing? Are you happy with us now? Now, Verona's not quite there yet. Madison's just getting warmed up here. Everybody else should be good. Is there a little guy? Where's the little guy? I think we got him already. We'll assume we got him. Everyone loved us today, pretty much. We got all the eggs. Not there. Okay. It's already taken. It's all our eggs. Okay. Still, we're going to have a pretty good day for that. We're already back up to 12,000. That's where we started today. We bought 2 goats. That was $8,000 right there. And we're already up to back up where we started this episode up. Pretty good. Pretty good. All right. Let's drop off some stuff to sell. Let's get rid of the seaweed. It's been in our pack for too long here. Let's get on Reno here. And he can bring us over to the other side of the farm here. Over to our brew area. All right. So hops. Blueberries, tomatoes. Are tomatoes lucrative? Are tomatoes like silver lot? Yeah, I don't know if it's worth it to make those into jelly or jam or anything like that. Is it a fruit or is it a vegetable? It's a vegetable, so it would be pickled tomatoes. We'll save them for recipes. Actually, I don't really think we need anything special for those, so we'll just keep these for recipes. I'm sure there's a couple that take tomatoes, and then we'll sell off some more of those later. Okay, so that can go then too. Now we've got the day ahead of us. What do we want to do with it? I think what we want to do is maybe head over to the desert again today. And, we'll get some more star fruit, get some more cactus fruit, get some star fruit seeds. Get some rhubarb seeds. I believe they sell rhubarb there. Maybe a rhubarb. Oh, you know what? Rhubarb is actually sold from the general store. So that means we have to wait till spring to get more of that, unfortunately. I probably should have saved one back just so we could make seeds from it. Ah, that's a good idea. Maybe save one of everything. I'm gonna need a special chest for that. Make sure you have at least just one of everything. That we can make seeds from that. That's a really, really good idea. Let's see, we got wood here. How many chests do you think I'm gonna need for this project? 1, 2 at least to start with. And we'll put our seed vault in. We'll put our seed vault in our bedroom, actually. This will be the seed vault. Okay, so we need one of everything. I'll grab one of every raw fruit out of here. One of those, one of these, one of these. Can't grow that. One of these. One of these. Can't do that. Can't do that. Okay. So all these are fruits and vegetables. Yep. And we'll put fruits in one, we'll put vegetables in another. Does that make sense? Spice berries, I don't think we can actually grow. Oranges, we can't grow either. Peppers, we can, though. Cactus fruit, we can't. Oh, here's tomatoes. Instead of using a nice tomato, I'll use a bad tomato. Garlic, bok choy, green beans, parsnips, kale. Anything else? That should take care of it. Yeah, so the idea here is that if we need seeds for something, for our greenhouse or whatever, we can always go into here and grab them out. Hot peppers are fruit. Everything else is a vegetable. Cool. And then we'll grab out some of the stuff out of the chest over here, I think. There should be more of the stuff that we haven't used up yet. Oh, we forgot to water our stuff here. Shoot. Never going to grow if we don't water it. This is just to complete the quest line. I don't actually need the hay. That should do it. And it's going to rain tomorrow, so that is the 4 days, I think, for it to grow. Radish, yes. Save one of those. Kale we have. Grapes we can't use. Oh, we were pickling tomatoes. Okay. Well, I guess we need to pickle something. It'll be around. It's in like 3 different spots now, so it's taking way too much more room than it should. That's okay. Not a huge deal. But we do want to throw these things in here before we forget. So let's grab this and radishes go in there. Okay, cool. And then out of the other chest, I should have just gone over there quick while I was over there already. And is there anything in here we can, the hops? Yeah, we can, so we can definitely grab a hops. So melon, hops, and blueberries. Okay, one of each. And that way we're covered if we need seeds for anything at all. The emergency seed vault. Which, if you're not familiar, there's a seed vault. I think it's in Norway. And it is just a, basically a repository of all seeds on the planet in case there's like any kind of like pandemic that destroys all the crops of a certain kind or something like that. You can always regrow them using those seeds in there. You know, the apocalypse happens or something like that. You can have your seeds on reserve just in case. That's one of those emergency things. I think it might be Norway or Iceland or something like that. But yeah. Pretty cool idea. Glad something like that exists in reality. It sounds like something out of like a sci-fi show or something like that, but it really, really exists. Not that, okay. So we're half the day through here. Maybe we should head over there. Let's see what our luck is today, and then we'll decide what we want to do. So the luck says, displeased with us today. All right, maybe we shouldn't head over there. We will save it for lucky day. We won't go over there today. What else can we do today? Let's make sure our slimes are happy. Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh. There was three slime egg things in there. Oh god. Okay. I think we just gotta click these to break them. 15 from that one. 15 for this one. Holy cow. And avoid all these. We might have overpopulated the slime stuff here. We can probably thin the herd a little bit, I think. These just keep multiplying. As long as there's water in here, they multiply. Oh my gosh. It's a dangerous thing to go in here. Okay, let's kill some of these guys off. Don't want to kill off too many. Oh, they're mating already. Look at these guys over here. Get away from me, you. Oh, look, you got a little baby. Two little babies. See, this is what I mean. They just keep multiplying. Oh, I killed the babies. Oh, no, I didn't mean to do that. Okay, well, that'll thin the herd a little bit in here. Oh, my gosh. Dangerous stuff, right? Slime ranching is not easy. Not easy. All right, so chickens are taken care of. Trees over here are good. Everything's growing fine. Yeah. I think if we use floor, though, we wouldn't have the problem we're having right now. Was there any kind of floor we can use that's not, like, ridiculous? The weathered floor, crystal floors, refined quartz. We're not going to do that. We needed a lot for this. This is only one per wood. I don't want to do that per se, because that doesn't look quite right. Let's go see what they're selling at the general store here. Oh, we got a little bit of honey. We'll sell it off to you. Summer Spangled Honey. And it'll do, let's go drop some stuff off with Gunther real quick. We'll have time. He's open a little bit later than everybody else is. We'll drop this stuff off at the community center. We'll hold off on the melons because we might want to do the pumpkins eventually. Take the pan with us. Take this with us. That should do it. Fried egg goes with us. We're not going to make it to Clint's on time. We could try it. If we get over there in time, we'll do this just in case. I don't think we'll get to Clint's on time unless we use the minecarts. Probably get there then. All right, let's do it quick. Actually, we're not going to be able to get to both, though. The general store and Clint's. Yeah, maybe we really, really hurry. All right, Clint, what do you got for us? No. Okay, here we go. Process geodes. Huh? Gotten that one already. Stone is fine with me. Well, we just got that one now. That might be new. Fairy stone. Hey, iridium. That's a nice find. That's definitely new. I have no idea what that is. Sandstone, maybe? That's something new, too. Jasper. All right. Okay, so let's get over to the general store quick if we can. I don't think we're going to make it there on time. It's already 3:30, and I'm sure they close at 4. We'll try it. Oh, we're going to get there at the nick of time, and it's going to close as soon as we get in there. We're going. Don't walk away. Okay, cool. All right, we want to sell off the honey. That's it. Anything else we want to grab from him? Oh, the flooring. That's right. Flooring. I want the flooring recipes. I don't want to just buy the flooring. So that's not quite what I want. More trees? We're running out of time for fall fruit. Pomegranates and apples are all we have. They take 28 days to mature, which from this point will be ready mid-fall for them to grow. But we need at least one more tree, I think. We also want trees of other time frames too, though. But then again, these are gonna be much easier to buy later on once we get more cash on hand. Given the way things are gonna go here, I think we'll have plenty of cash in the future here to plant the orchards that we want. So I think I'll just buy one apple today, and we'll get that in the ground today, hopefully. And then, that's what we'll do. Okay, so. Got that taken care of. I forgot that he doesn't sell the recipes for flooring, he just sells the actual floors. Bring me a wheat? I guess? I'm not doing that. We want the wheat today? 75 gold. Abigail, you're weird. All right, let's get over to the museum before it closes. I think they close at 6, so we probably have enough time to get there. We'll keep our eyes out for places to pan, too. I did bring it with us for that purpose. All right, there's got to be enough stuff in here to get another level here, I think, right? Donate. Got a few things. This is filled up already. Oh, okay. Down here, let's rearrange some things here. The tools and stuff are going over here for the most part. The dwarf scrolls don't fit over here though. Jasper can go here, I guess. Wow, still a level up. Wow, no level up still. We're only 4 things away though from the end here though. All right, nothing to donate. What is some of the stuff we turned in there? Amphibian fossil, we turned that in already, okay. We turned this one. This was sandstone, I think. Sandstone, yeah. Jagoite. High volume of tiny crystals make it very glittery. All right. And the last thing we need to do is stop at the community center and drop off our few things we have to turn in. Get a little closer to that. And then that'll be it for this episode. So, we're running long here. I'll just cut to the community center and then we'll wrap it up. All right, we're ready. Turn in some of the good stuff here. No, don't drink the milk. No, don't drink the milk. Jeez, you really want to drink that milk. Not that. Fodder bundle, that's what we're here for. The hay is good, the wheat we're working on. And then the apples we should have in the fall. The milk is turned in over here. And then we're one step away. Well, 2 steps away. 2 steps away from completing this quest line. One large milk. Now we're waiting on wool or goat's milk now. Oh, man. It's going to be good. Now he's got to take really good care of our animals here. And that's it. That's all there is to it. I'm nervous about this, though. I really am nervous about the kitchen here, that it's going to pop up and say, hey, you got one more quest to do. But that's the two stars left. The bulletin board and the one over there. That does take care of it, though. Chef's bundle, fried egg. So here we're just waiting on the truffle, which requires us to get pigs. So we need to get our barn upgraded then too. So for the entire community center, we need both things upgraded. Good to know. Good to know. And then for the enchanter's bundle, I'm not too sure about. Dye bundle, we need a few other things. Red cabbage we're working on. Sunflower, I'm not too sure about. That might be a fall thing. Duck feather we find randomly. I think the ducks have a chance of giving it to us also. So we might find this with our ducks randomly. We still haven't turned in the red mushroom. That's surprising. We have that all over the place, though. That's not a big deal. So we're not too far away from this one, really. I just don't know if it's sunflower. I think that's probably a fall product. It might be a spring, unfortunately. But maybe, I think I have seen it at the traveling merchant occasionally. If we ever remember to go down there. I'm going to be kicking myself when we see him selling stuff we need to get. Is it worthwhile to go talk to Krobus? Maybe he likes a fossil. You think he likes a fossil? Probably not. He might like some weird stuff like that, though. Who knows? We'll see if he's into fossils. Not like we're super good friends anyways. Speaking of friends, we haven't given our friends any gifts this much here lately. Okay, I guess I'll accept it. Okay, he was not into that one. So we're... Oh, maybe we should get the star drop. Yeah. Next chance we get, next 20,000 we'll get was to get that, because that's going to help us overall, like, across the board. It's very expensive, though. But, you know, well, lucrative, you know, vineyard owners like me will have no problem coming up with that kind of cash pretty soon here. So, and that'll help us, you know, help us with the caverns more, having more energy, having more health, help us with, you know, just general farming, using up less energy, fishing, everything helps across the board. So we'll save up our pennies for that. I also want to save up for the upgrades for the coop and the barn so we can get working on those things. And achieve our goals there. I think the one we need more is the barn upgraded first now, because we can get wool. We have the goats already. We can get wool from rabbits, I believe. I think it's wool. It doesn't make any sense. It'd be sheep, right? But sell these off. I'm gonna keep those for any reason. Okay, we'll hang on to that, obviously. Sweet pea we'll hang on to for gifts. We'll get the sapling in the ground right away here. And get this cheese pulled out. And the sapling will go over here. Fitting in the mold here. So we can do another row of the other kind of seasonal trees here. And also, eventually, once we get really crazy, we'll have enough money to like fill this whole thing with an orchard over here too. Maybe. That will be nuts once we can do that. But it's going to happen. Once we start getting more money from our vineyard, we'll be getting like 20,000 a day at some point. It won't be any problem whatsoever. We'll clear that out. The stump is not grown yet. We'll keep an eye on it still. All right, so that's going to do it for this episode. Thank you guys for watching. Sorry it ran long, but I know some of you guys don't mind that so much. But I usually try to keep them about 30 minutes, 40 minutes sometimes, based on the length of the episodes here. And the length of the days, we have so much to do, you know, and our energy never runs out, so we can use up the every single day to it's good to last drop generally. So thank you guys again for watching. I really appreciate it. And I'll see you guys next time for more. Have a good night.